You know what really pisses me off? Being wrong. And what pisses me off even more is people that are wrong and that claim to be right. And we tend to do this to ourselves also. If I look back at my history, like, you want to follow people that are bullish at the bottom and bearish at the top, and that have a minority exposure or no exposure at the top, and have a majority exposure or a all-in exposure at the bottom. Like, that's how you make money. But that's so difficult, because at the top, well, everybody is bullish, and so are you, and so am I. So you really have to fight incredible forces to be bearish and to sell, and to sell something that has done so well for you, and to lock it into another asset that has done so poorly. But yeah, when I look at my own history, I made a tweet, I will link it below. What were the tweets that I was making at the top? And the top was between 15th of December and the 15th of January of 2017, 2018, and 2017, start 2018. The market cap was above 550 billion. It peaked out at 830 billion, but only for a couple of days. So, but you can call that whole period the top. And what are my tweets and what are my videos? I do have a couple of videos that are bearish and one for a correction, and a couple of tweets, but the majority of my tweets are bullish. I think it will go higher. I'm promoting coins left and right, my favorite coins, Bitball and Bitcoin Cash I'm promoting. And I think that it will go higher, the market, it will hit 1 trillion. And my own exposure is that I'm invested the majority in crypto, still at the top, 70% or so. So I was wrong, for the most part. And even if I... Yeah, I was not a great leader, I was not a great example. I didn't help that many people, actually, to lock in profits. I did it a little bit, but not a lot. And at the bottom, it was the same story. The bottom, if that was the bottom, I still think that was not the bottom, but that's not of importance. We just look at the history here. The only thing we know right now is that the prices, the lowest prices were at $3,200. You can call any price below $3,500 the bottom, and that period was two periods. First period was in December the 15th, when that bottom was reached, but it was already below 3,500 on not the 15th of December, but the 7th of December, a week before. And a couple of days later it went above 3,500, so it was only about a good week that was below $3,500, but then it came back $3,500 in January, also for a week. So you had 2 weeks of bottoms. And if I look at my own tweets made during that period and my own videos, yes, it's mixed, the same story. I make some bullish videos, for example, BCH, Mary BCH, where I say it's a great buy, Bitcoin Cash, and prices are tremendous, and I'm bullish on that. I recommend people to buy it. But what are my own actions? Well, actually, I didn't buy any. I bought at $250, a big stash, and then I didn't buy any as it continued to collapse to $200, $150, $100, at $80, I didn't buy anything. Yeah, I put some bullish videos out, but I didn't buy them. So, and also I make lots of tweets that I think it will go lower.
Huh?
And that the bottom is not in. So I think that my performance is only mixed, and I don't think that's a great performance, and it shows in my results also. They are also only mixed.
Huh?
So
yeah,
and I think this kind of analysis you should really do with the people that you follow, because just click on my tweet there and you click on those links and you just have to change the name. And you will see what tweets they were making. It's, I can tell you, the results are just horrendous. Horrendous. Of people that you think are great, like are helpful, but you really look into it. Actually, no, that's not really true. Huh? Like, I don't know anyone actually that has done a great job there. So if you find someone, please let me know. But I think that's why it's so important to follow the basic principles of investing. And because everybody gets tricked by this, one more than the other, but like it's very, very rare to have someone who is bearish at the top and who is actually selling strong to a minority position or selling it all. It's very rare. Huh? And then we're talking about not the absolute top. No, no, we just talk about like the range. Yeah? Like we talk about a month's time, yeah, or 2 weeks' time, where prices are like above 550 billion or below $3,500. Like it's not just one day. Like you have the chance to sell over a period of 2 weeks to up to a month, or to buy over a period of 2 weeks of up to a month, but very, very few people do. Yes, you have people that dollar cost average and they end up doing this, but the percentage of their capital that they invest at these prices is negligible. Huh? Like we're talking about 1%, like that's negligible. That's not buying the bottom, and that's not selling the top. That's just called DCA, dollar cost averaging, and then you buy at all prices, and your average price is a lot different than selling the top or buying the bottom. Huh? So very, very few people succeed in that. And so how can you do well knowing this? Well, it's to follow the Kelly criterion, which I have been evangelizing for many, many years, and I have still not mastered, because I don't act upon it.
Huh?
And the Kelly criterion is very simple. Your bet size needs to be in direct correlation to the risk reward ratio. So when you're at top prices at 550 billion plus, or at 120, below 120 billion actually, sorry, I was not talking about Bitcoin price below 3,500. These periods are actually when the total market cap is below 120 billion. That was for 2 weeks, but two different weeks in December and January. Like, what should your allocation be on such a time? When prices are above 550 billion, which happened for 1 month, what should your allocation be? That's simple. A minority position. Even if you think it will double from there, which I thought it would peak out at 1 trillion, should you have a majority position? No. No. Because that's not certain at all that it will double yet another time. It was coming from 3 billion. If you're at 500 billion, you did times 100 already. Eh? Times 200 almost. Should you then stay invested to have another doubling? After you had 10 doublings or so, or 5 doublings, you want to do the 6th doubling or the 11th doubling, and that's why you're going to stay invested with majority? No, that's just extremely high risk, because if you estimate that wrongly, and actually that is the top and you go down from there, well, you miss out on tremendous, tremendous gains that you could have locked in that you end up not doing. So you should be already at the minority or scale down to a minority position right there.
Huh?
And you can also correlate it, this to the Trololo chart, where you see the overvaluation. So the moment overvaluation was around probably 500% or so, it peaked out at 700%, I think, something like that. But like, yes, you should not sell down if you're only at 100% overvaluation. Then you should not go to a minority share. But when you start to approach valuations, like when we were at 700% overvaluation, I thought it would go to 900. That's why I didn't sell down. 900% overvaluation would have been 1 trillion. So I was thinking, gonna go higher, no time to sell strong yet. But it ended up being only 700% overvaluation, and that was the top 800 billion. So the mistake was that I had my margin of safety was not high enough. And that was a tremendous mistake. Even if you're bullish at the top, you should still, even if you're bullish at like 500 billion or at 500% overvaluation, you should have, or I should have, gone down to a minority exposure. That was the right move. And then see it go up more to 800, yeah, sure, but continue to sell to an even lower exposure. And you go to 40%, but then you go to 30% or to 20%. Like, you keep on selling as it goes up to a smaller and smaller exposure. That's the right move. Because you're gonna be bullish at the top. That's almost inevitable. But you still have to be disciplined and sell down to a minority share. It's the same today in this bear market, but in the other way around. We are in undervaluation. So you should have a majority exposure. That's the general rule. But the same story applies. You shouldn't go immediately, the moment you hit undervaluation, go to a majority exposure. No, you have to let it run a little. You have to look at the historical performance there. And then you apply a margin of safety before you go to a majority exposure. So in the past, we've seen that compared to the trend line, it went to minus 50%. That was the bottom. But then it went sideways, and then we went to an undervaluation of minus 70%. And that was not the bottom, but it was still, from a risk-reward ratio perspective, it was even a better buy. But prices were actually around the market cap went up at that time to 15 billion. It dropped to 5 billion, to 3 billion. That was the bottom. That was 50% undervaluation. But then it went up probably to 4 or 5 billion 1 year later. But undervaluation was even higher, at minus 70%. So What was the right move there? Well, no, let's look at what's the right move today. We saw that in the bear market before, the undervaluation was lower. It never went to minus 70%, but it did go to also minus 50%, but that was the peak. So we see minus 50%, minus 70%. So very likely we will have an undervaluation of minus 80%. Or maybe minus 85% this time. But it will take a long time to get there after the sideways movement. So that's probably only in a year from here or so. But I don't want to buy that. I want to buy the actual bottom, trying to buy the actual fiat bottom. So if we look at that, that happened at minus 50%. Two times. No, at minus 30% it happened. Sorry, I will link the chart below. Take a look at it too. One moment. Let me just take a look myself. Yeah, so last two bear markets in 2011 and 2015 at minus 50%. You had the, and that was also the first time it went into undervaluation. We had the bottom. Now we also went to minus 50%, and it might well be that that was indeed also the bottom. When it went to $3,200 or 110 billion or so, it didn't go below 100 billion, but it came very close, below 120 billion, you can call that the bottom for now. But that was also at minus 50% undervaluation, so you never know what's gonna be the bottom. But the Trello chart can really help in judging whether we're in undervaluation or not, and whether we're in serious undervaluation or not. And yes, at minus 50% we were in serious undervaluation, and that was the time to go to majority exposure. But I already did it, I think, at minus 30%, and then it dropped to minus 50%, so I was too soon. And now we're back at minus 30%, and I sold down to a minority exposure. I only have 40% now. But I'm playing with fire. That's dangerous. Because you should never sell a position that you're taking in during a bear market. Or you should never buy back during a bull market. When you're at serious overvaluation, then you're playing with fire. Same in a bear market. When you're at serious undervaluation, you should never sell your coins on a rebound. But in this case, we went to minus 50% undervaluation, and then we went up to from about 100 billion, 110 billion to 180 billion. In 3 months time, and to minus 30% undervaluation. And considering that the cycles extend and the pattern in the cycles become longer and longer, and in the past over undervaluation has gone up over time, not down but up, I think it's worth a risk taking here. But it's still a risk, and that's why I decide to go to 60% again, a majority exposure, if Bitcoin Cash would hit $200. If Bitcoin Cash is now back at 300, 310 or 320, something like that, it keeps on hitting its top the past 2 weeks, 3 weeks. But if it falls back to $200, likely that will be if Bitcoin falls back from 5,000 to 4,500 or so, maybe 4,200, I have to buy back to a majority share. It's not like I have a choice here, because there is a chance that the bull market has started, a small chance, but a chance that the bull market has started, and that the best available here is just a small correction before we continue to go back up. So I really have to go back to majority position, as we have seen that minus 50% undervaluation again, and we have had a great buying opportunity, and so it was justified to go to a majority position again according to the Trello chart. And you should keep that majority position, and selling that off is a very risky thing. That if you're gonna do that, well, make sure you buy it back quickly. So that's why I stick to my exposure target to be back at the majority crypto if Bitcoin or crypto corrects, but not even corrects a lot. So if you go to about 180 billion to maybe 150 billion or so, yes, I will do that. But at the same time, yes, moving in gradually is extremely important. If you make too big of a step, then you won't buy if it continues to go down, and you won't buy, you will be frozen like I was, and you won't take advantage of the opportunity, and people will become more bearish, and so will you, and so will I, and all videos will start to be about how low it will go and that the bottom is not in. But so you do need to buy. How do you do that? By forcing yourself to follow the Kelly criterion. And by looking at this, the numbers, and just looking at objective numbers like how high is the undervaluation. And if it goes up, you have to raise your exposure. So that's why I will go to 80% if Bitcoin Cash reaches $100, and to 100% if Bitcoin Cash reaches $50. Or if you want to chart it out on the Trello chart, well, if we hit another 50%, that's not a milestone, because in the meantime, trend line has gone up the past 3 months. So a new 50% undervaluation will actually be a higher fiat price. But if you go to a new all-time low or all-time high of undervaluation, that's like 60% or 65%, if we reach that. And it's not in a year, but it's over the next month, 2 months, then that will likely be a new fiat low, and it has very high odds to be the actual bottom. Because to reach that 85% that won't be hit anytime soon, that cannot be hit right now, but it can only be hit at the end of the sideways movement, and that should take a lot longer. That's because if you reach a new bottom, then actually there is no sideways movement, because you just hit a new low. So that's per definition not a sideways movement. So per definition, the sideways movement will be a lot further in time, and it's only after that movement that you will have the biggest undervaluation compared to the trend line. So you cannot expect that to hit when you hit a new fiat low, but very likely that will be the bottom. So if that would be reached, a new 65% undervaluation, then I will probably have to change also my plan and go all in, even if my Bitcoin Cash bottom has not been reached of $50, because Bitcoin Cash is changing. It lost a lot of support and market cap due to the split with Bitcoin SV, but now Bitcoin SV is going down the drain as it gets delisted by big exchanges, and some of that value has been coming back to Bitcoin Cash. So this lowers the chances for Bitcoin Cash to find a new low, even when Bitcoin finds a new low. And other Bitcoins like Ethereum find a new low, Bitcoin Cash may not find a new low. So when Bitcoin makes a new low, and big important coins like Ethereum make new lows, then even if Bitcoin Cash doesn't make a new low, it may be worthwhile to go all in already. So keeping an eye on that. Thanks so much for watching. And please remain critical towards the people you follow, towards me. And thank you so much for all the critical feedback that I get from you guys. It's very valuable. Bye.